到你打理解吗？
有运动没？
分得仲唔使啦，做得啦。
咁我又攞自由啦，系咪？好，先翻我哋啦，我排队攞自由。呢边先，后边嘅。喐佢喎。
中間係嘛？中間係嘛 ？OK，OK，OK，OK。好啊。我依家又有冇英文嘅記者啊？
有啊。
OK
啊，
我驚後面得唔得？唔得 ，OK 好。咁我講咗中文先，跟住簡單英文複述啦，好唔好啊？好，就咁我喺11月22日咧就報咗名參加元朗八鄉嘅元江新村嘅居民代表選舉啦。咁我強調呢個係一個好小規模啦，選民得嗰幾百人嘅一個鄉村嘅選舉啦。咁喺呢個立法會九龍西補選。之後有結果之後的翌日，即是昨日呢，咁我就收到呢個選舉主任，即是元朗的民政專員，就俾咗5条問題我去答咁樣。咁其實呢啲答問題嗰個情況都唔係第一次見啦咁樣。咁所以我都唔詳細講。咁但係呢我就第一樣嘢想講呢，就係因為其實根據法例呢，一個要參加村代表選舉的人呢，他在政治上他要表達的或者聲明的，就是他擁護基本法，同埋呢是效忠特別行政區，咁咪得呢兩個條件嘅啫。咁而我本人呢，第一就喺11月22日就有一個聲明，即係我做咗一個提名的表格裏面已經有呢個聲明㗎啦。咁另外咧，我都有特別向選舉主任提到咧，我喺就任我立法會呢個議員呢個職位嘅時候咧，即係2016年嘅時候，我喺公眾面前係有個宣誓嘅。呢個宣誓咧係得到立法會嘅秘書嘅確認啦。之後咧亦都係冇受到咧律政司。是以司法渠道去挑戰的，咁所以我是不明點解而家呢個村代表選舉的選舉主任咧，仲需要係畫蛇添足去問呢些問題？我認為他是濫用了呢個選舉條例咧俾佢嘅權力嘅，咁呢個是第一點啦。咁喺嗰5条問題裏面咧，我相信咧大家。都是集中看最尾那條的，因為最尾那條呢，他的問題就是問 你本人是否提倡或支持香港獨立是自決前途的選項咁樣。咁呢個都係過去嗰我諗一年半載呢，即係對於所謂嗰條紅線呢，要由呢、這個港獨就去到自決嘅時候呢，嗰、那個理由就係咁樣嘅，即係好似一個不成文嘅紅線已經畫咗出嚟咁樣。咁呢我就就住呢個問題呢，首先我想同大家講呢，呢、這個問題本身呢係好有引導性同埋好容易令人誤解嘅，所以我就用多咗一啲篇幅呢去回答選舉主任，同埋希望向公眾可以說明到嘅。咁第一呢就係、是、我主張嘅自決前途呢，其實佢個背景呢就係、是、相對於過去民主運動嘅雙普選呢個議程喺831人大決定之後，佢冇辦法再向前行。咁到底作為香港人，我哋係咪就咁坐咗喺度呢？抑或係我哋要更加深入咁去睇，到底我哋而家呢一國兩制、基本法呢個制度底下，係咪有啲框框係框住咗我哋成個城市嘅市民、香港人去攞返我哋對於呢個前途嘅決定權呢？咁喺呢個問題上面呢，我有嗰啲具體嘅主張嘅，譬如話基本法第158條同159條嘅修訂呢，其實佢係而家我哋見到呢兩條嘅條文係調返轉頭，無論你有冇普選啊，你都發覺北京係借住呢兩條條文呢去介入香港嘅政治同埋各方面嘅施政嘅。咁所以呢喺我主張嘅嗰個自決前途裏面呢，其實佢係一個範圍好闊嘅，主要係關乎呢我哋如何去就住而家嗰個憲政基礎，即係基本法裏面嘅問題，有冇一個方法，或者有冇啲部分我哋要係提出糾正嘅，共同提出令到香港真係邁向一個民主，我哋自己可以決定自己嘅命運，而唔係俾北京咧去限制我哋未來嘅選擇。嗱，呢一個問題嘅第二點咧，延伸落去咧，就係咁喺香港有人去主張香港獨立，咁我認為係點咧？我認為呢一個和平地主張香港獨立咧，係基本法賦予咗香港人嘅權力嚟嘅。咁所以有人去主張呢係冇問題嘅，我認為。但係我冇主張嘛，我冇主張嘛。跟住就去到第三點啦，我認為其實而家政府呢條問題，或者嗰個所謂自決派嗰個紅線嗰個最令人覺得荒謬嘅地方呢，就係我唔單止係我唔可以主張香港獨立或者支持香港獨立，我呢係必須呢要反對埋其他人去主張，甚至我要係主動去禁止人哋去主張香港獨立，我先至叫做係擁護基本法同埋係效忠特區。嗱，我覺得呢個係一個好荒謬嘅邏輯嚟嘅，因為呢個邏輯呢就好似外國記者會嘅前副主席馬凱咁樣，就係佢其實唔主張噶，但係佢因為主持咗嗰個陳浩天呢一個演講咧，佢就被人政治報復啦。我認為咧，如果選舉主任呢條問題背後嗰個意思就係話，你唔單止你唔可以支持，仲要係人哋支持都唔得，你又唔可以俾人哋支持。咁我覺得呢個係違反基本法同埋人權法對於我嗰個講嘢嘅自由嘅保障啊。咁我好講多一部講多啲就關於呢個部分，係因為呢我哋實在混咗喺呢個問題裏面太耐啦，即係話自決作為紅線就係咩意思呢？就係話哦，你哋就係容許港獨作為選項，其實呢個係好搞笑荒謬嘅講法嚟嘅。我自己冇主張，咁你就話我唔可以令到人哋去主張，我唔同意呢個講法，所以我唔認為選舉主任可以咁樣咧，就話我冇 擁護基本法，同埋咧係效忠特區嘅。最尾咧，我想講咧就係、是其實而家北京對香港嗰個政治干預咧係好嚴重，不斷去踐踏香港人無論係言論自由、結社組黨嘅自由，以至於參政嘅自由，去到一個地步咧，連美國都話要係考慮停止香港嗰個獨立關稅區嘅地位。我好希望咧，特區政府唔好再將呢一啲政治審查繼續咁去擴大。我哋要嘅係將呢啲政治審查拎翻走佢，還翻俾香港人咧，我哋自由講嘢、自由參政嘅權利。我咧係好坦誠咁樣去將我自己心裏面諗嘅關於一啲政治主張咧，雖然我覺得冇需要同呢個選舉主任交代，但係我覺得對於公眾或者對於傳媒朋友，我覺得係一個負責任嘅做法，要講翻清楚。咁我咧係認為選村長咧係無論係我或者係其他人咧，都唔需要咧係面對呢一種荒謬嘅政治審查嘅。咁我希望咧，我係最後一個。咁而至於你話我會唔會因此被取消資格，或者之後我有咩打算嗰啲，其實我而家係冇辦法可以答到大家嘅。咁我大概係講到呢度先。
你擔唔擔心咧？即係你寫埋你而家呢一個諗法落去，就係話你自己唔同意，但係你都唔會阻止人哋去同意呢樣嘢，因為寫咗落去都影響到佢唔俾你選。
因為我覺得咧，大家如果記得嘅話咧，喺香港民族黨被呢、這個保安局咧去取締嘅時候咧，其實我哋成個民主派咧都係一致出嚟話，就算你唔同意呢、這個主張，但係冇理由佢和平地去講說話，跟住有個組織，跟住你又要禁黨，跟住又唔俾佢講說話。甚至要懲罰嗰啲佢身邊嘅人，呢個係我認為好合理嘅一個立場，亦都係我一路相信嘅立場。我唔覺得我要因為要答呢封信就要去扭曲呢個立場。咁至於呢個立場，我認為係站得住腳嘅。就住我係咪可以被視為去擁護基本法或者係效忠特區？咁我今日都有同我法律團隊去傾過啦。咁如果面對要喺之後有打官司嘅情況嘅話，我哋係有準備去捍衛呢一個咁合理嘅立場咯。
With regards to your final question, your answer, you did not directly give a yes-no answer on the point on self-determination. Instead, you said that if you're asking, it could violate if they're asking you to object, to oppose to those people calling for Hong Kong independence, it could violate your freedom of speech, could violate basic law and the Bill of Rights in Hong Kong. So could you explain that viewpoint? And are you concerned that you could be disqualified because of that answer?
Well, I think the question itself is very misleading to ask me to say yes or no that whether Hong Kong independence can be a choice in our process of self-determination. Because, well, first of all, I did not push for a referendum in Hong Kong. What I'm pushing for is a thorough review of the current constitutional system, including certain articles in the basic law, for example, Article 158 and 159, that gives the central government huge power to intervene in internal politics of Hong Kong. So, and I find the logic of the returning officer very weird that he not only, I mean, the rationale behind his question not only asked me not to support independence of Hong Kong, but not allowing me to say, not allowing me to have other people proposing Hong Kong independence. And I think this is the right, this is the basic right of a Hong Kong citizen to voice out his wish for Hong Kong independence. Although it is not my political belief, I think they have the right. So I think it is very unreasonable to force me not only claiming my own political belief, but to account for other people's belief. 其實我喺報名嗰日咧，我都同呢個助理選舉主任講，因為佢都有問我呢個問題。我嘅答案就係好簡單嘅，我係睇翻法例嘅。法例咧，佢係要求我去簽一個聲明，就係擁護基本法同埋效忠香港特別行政區。咁我喺個報名表裏面咧已經有呢一個聲明喺裏面嘅，我就同佢講話。我只會做法例要求嘅嘢，係唔會做多嘅。
你自己點樣評估先？你唔知都話已經好難講啦。你自己評估，因為而家呢個政治氣氛之下，俾人 DQ 嘅機會有幾大？
嗱，而家我認為咧，而家係北京以至特區政府濫用佢哋嘅權力咧，係冇露足嘅，係任意嘅。所以作為一個香港的政治人物呢， 我會相信呢企席在這裡講我的信念，合理的信念，亦都我認為是符合這個選舉條例的信念呢，是我的本分來的。我做完我的本分之後會發生什麼事呢？個責任不在我這裡，個責任是在任意地去濫用他的權力去取消資格的人身上。Can you repeat the first question?
Are you worried that you're going to disqualify?
Well, I am not worried since there are already many people ahead of me being disqualified either as candidates orAs legislators, so I'll not be the first one, and I just hope that Carrie Lam and her government stops hindering our basic rights to run in office. This is how the city can be a harmonious one. If you keep on disqualifying candidates, disqualifying young people from running, well, you cannot come up with a good result in her governance.
即係你有講到話嗰個港獨就係主張咧，咁其實可以理解你講嘅決前途係入邊係冇任何港獨嘅即係做選項，係咪可以咁樣理解？
我的講法就是話咧，我好似頭先所講啦，前途自決咧，佢作為一個主張咧，佢唔係一個好確定嘅主張嚟嘅。我唔係話我哋幾時就要搞一個公民投票，咁而呢個公民投票裏面咧就要有幾多個項目俾大家揀咁樣，咁。所以咧，其實政府不斷去以呢一個問題嘅框架去擺喺我面前咧，我覺得係誤導咗公眾，同埋係扭曲咗我的意思嘅。所以我就用頭先我嗰三點咧去回應選舉主任嗰個問題。我希望唔好 將呢個問題繼續擺喺大家嘅腦裏面，覺得好似我哋講前途自決就只有佢呢種講法，或者有呢種問法同埋答法，而係我哋其實正如我哋香港未來嘅民主前路一樣咧，其實唔會有一條一定指定嘅路，就係好似過去2014年之前講哦雙普選啊，總之有雙普選之後咧，香港就會一片光明啦。其實八三一之後，大家都知道，其實我哋要向整個一國兩制同埋到底我哋而家嗰個憲政嘅基礎，呢本基本法到底佢入邊有啲咩內容係令到我哋香港人而家冇辦法去主宰我哋自己嘅命運呢？咁我係希望翻去呢本基本法度去揾答案嘅。咁當然我強調就係話有朋友認為佢唔想喺呢本基本法揾答案，佢要喺其他地方揾答案，包括香港獨立呢、這個，只要佢係和平地去主張呢樣嘢，我唔認為佢係要好似過去一段日子，無論陳浩天或者FCC 或者馬海的遭遇咁樣，係要俾人千夫所指，跟住喺香港消失咯。
You mentioned that it's hard to assess your chances in being disqualified or be able to run in this election. Do you feel that the Hong Kong government is tightening its control on elections in general from the questions that you are asked to answer?
But definitely the government is tightening its control to political participation. I can imagine that one day they can interpret the meaning of uphold of the basic law supporting one party rule in mainland China. That may become the prerequisite of running in election.我其實我哋未研究到咁仔細嘅，咁但係我認為我呢個個案咧，佢都如果一個普通嘅香港人，你聽下我講，就係我而家係一個現任嘅立法會議員，咁我宣誓嘅時候就係講緊我擁護基本法同埋效忠香港特別行政區，咁我而家做咗兩年幾啦。咁我去選一個元朗一條幾百人嘅村嘅村代表選舉，結果呢我係會被取消資格嘅。我認為市民係聽得明當中嘅荒謬咯。我覺得唔係講緊話我哋要喺馬上可以喺法庭嗰度攞翻個公道啊，因為未去到嗰個階段。但係起碼從一個公眾嘅討論嘅層次，市民應該睇到那個問題在邊度啊嘛？點解美國政府會忽然間出咗啲 report 啊，話要話一國兩制實施有問題呢？今次如果我作為一個村代表的參選人都可以咁樣被取消資格，而我是一個現任立法會議員，呢、這個咪正正是一個説明我哋香港出現咗問題咯，公眾是會睇到咯，所以佢唔係一個直接係一個司法上面我哋。是不是已經處心積慮啊？就是用我來去做個test case 咁樣，而係我認為喺個公眾輿論方面，我哋先要俾公眾明白，而家呢一種政治審查係嚴重到去呢個地步咯。一個立法會議員選村長係可能要被禁止，要經歷呢啲咁樣嘅無聊嘅政治審查。
頭先你講過咧，你唔係第一個有遭遇到呢啲政治審查啦，咁但係你希望你係最後一個。但
是
會不會都擔心其實這一些審查之後都會繼續出現？
我是很擔心啊，我很擔心香港啊。我想無論由記者的言論自由，到一個普通人他結社的自由，到我和很多香港人的參政的自由，其實現在都面臨很嚴重的威脅。這個是我很不想這樣的，但我想在每一個重要關頭 我同埋我身邊嘅支持民主或者反對呢個專制嘅人，就只能夠做好自己嘅本分咯。咁我哋都係期望所有人都做好自己嘅本分，去捍衛香港人基本嘅權利嘅時候，我哋總係會形成一個比起而家更加大嘅力量，去制止事情再惡化落去咯。好，唔該曬。